welcome to this week's Children's Online Service. So glad that you could join us for another week. I hope you're all well, you've all had a great week, and you're ready for an awesome Children's Online Service. So now it's time for a session of praise and worship. Let's prepare our hearts and our minds, and let's focus our minds on Jesus as we praise and we worship Him. Father, for that awesome time of praise and worship. We believe that you have indeed met us either in our homes or at church. You are indeed here with us, O Father Lord. Thank you for the opportunity to meet once again, to praise, to worship, to learn more about you, O Father Lord. We want to say thank you, O mighty Father. Thank you for our families, thank you for our friends, thank you for all those in our lives that you have put there, O God. We want to say a massive thank you, Lord. Father Lord, we bless this service, O Lord. We pray that you will have your way in this service, that you will speak to our hearts, that we will learn something new, that you will renew our minds in you, O Father Lord, that we will leave this service feeling that we are able to do all things through Christ Jesus, O Lord. We thank you that you've heard us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
It's offering time.
So now it's time for this week's lesson.
God's story, the Good Samaritan. So part of God's story is about a Good Samaritan, and it goes like this. When Jesus lived on earth, he often told stories to teach us things. Stories that teach a lesson are called parables. One day, Jesus told a parable about a good guy from a place called Samaria, a Good Samaritan, to a group of Jewish people. It all started when a Jewish expert in the law asked Jesus, "What must I do to receive eternal life?" Basically, he was asking, "What do I have to do to be perfect?" Since this guy was an expert in the law, he thought he already knew how to be perfect because he knew all the rules. He just wanted to see what Jesus would say. Of course, Jesus knew what the man was thinking, so he asked him, "What is written in the law?" The man said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as you love yourself." So he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus answered him by telling this story. A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Everybody listening was Jewish, and they could probably all picture the exact road Jesus was talking about. He continued, "A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. You might expect a priest, who was supposed to serve God, to help, but he didn't stop. Then Jesus said, a Levite came to the place and saw him, but he passed by on the other side too." Levites were assistants to priests, so maybe you'd expect them to help too, but he didn't stop either. Finally, Jesus said, a Samaritan came along. Remember, a Samaritan is a person from Samaria. That's near Israel, where God's family, the Jews, lived. But here's the thing. Jews and Samaritans didn't get along. In fact, nobody hearing this story would ever expect a Samaritan to help, because Samaritans and Jews couldn't stand each other. But Jesus said, when the Samaritan saw the man and took pity on him, he went to him and bandaged his wounds. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out money and gave it to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will pay you back for any extra expense you have." Then Jesus asked, "Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers?" The expert in the law didn't even want to say the word Samaritan, but he admitted, "The one who had mercy on him." Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise." In other words, go and love everyone, even people we don't like or people who everybody else wants to avoid. See, when we show love, we're obeying Jesus. Obeying God doesn't mean just doing what his rules say. It means loving him more than anything and showing his love to every single person that we meet. And that's the story of the Good Samaritan. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. A man asked Jesus how to get eternal life. Jesus said, "What is written in the law?" The man said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as you love yourself." Then the man asked, "Who is my neighbor?" Jesus told a story. If you missed Jesus' story, here's the quick version. A Jewish man got beat up. A priest walked by. A priest assistant passed by. A man from Samaria actually did help. That was a surprise. Jesus had taught them, we obey God when we show love. And that's part of God's story.
Amazing. I hope you enjoyed watching that lesson. I absolutely love the parable of the Good Samaritan. Jesus told the story of the Good Samaritan to show how we are to love our neighbor. The Good Samaritan stopped to help the Jewish man who had been attacked and robbed and, you would say, left for dead. Although the Jews and Samaritans couldn't stand each other, he went to extraordinary lengths to help the man and to care for the man. He showed so much compassion and kindness. We saw that he was bound up his wounds. He carried him on his donkey. He took care of him. He took him to the inn and paid for all his expenses. He definitely loved the Jewish man, as he would want someone to care and to love for him if he was in that situation. Jesus calls for us to love our neighbours as we love ourselves. And we all love ourselves. We all want to care for ourselves and want the best for ourselves. And our neighbours are not just the people who live near us or that are in our circles or our friends and family, but neighbours are not even just the people that go to our church or the people that we know or even just believers in Jesus. Neighbours are anyone who's in need. Sometimes helping our neighbour can be a bit difficult and a bit inconvenient, but we are to show our love, and through this we are obeying Jesus. We show our love to Jesus and through showing our love to others. For this week's new memory verse. And this week's memory verse is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 12, verses 30 to 31. And it reads, "Love the Lord your God, love him with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength." The second most important command is this: love your neighbor as you love yourselves. To love God with all our heart, all our soul, all our mind, and all our strength means that we should love God with our whole life. Everything we do should be things that make God happy. We should be obeying him. And through that, that's how we love God with our heart, our soul, strength, and our mind. And what does it mean to love other people as we love ourselves? It means we always want what's best for them, just like we want what's best for us. It means we won't hurt others as we wouldn't hurt ourselves, and would be kind to others because we're kind to ourselves. We are to love others as we love ourselves. We've got a special quiz for you all to complete. Let's see how many questions you can get right. well done to everyone who took part in the quiz and to everyone who got all the questions right or got some of them right. I hope you was able to recap on your knowledge on the Good Samaritan. So now it's time for us to share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. That's the end of the service. See you next Sunday.